can only really remember Bujang Lapok for the movies, and I can only really remember Getaran Jiwa for the music. It really felt like it was it could have been written by anyone, George Gershwin or any of the great composers, you know, of the 40s, that from where a lot of the jazz repertoire came from. It was just such a classic, well thought out composition. It's a world class composition. It can be sung in any language. Everything is very, very logical. I mean, you know, when you have music, how one chord moves to the other, and it's not simplistic. Like, very often compositions from regional or local composers from that time, very simplistic, you know, whereas the Getaran Jiwa was a very complex composition and a great piece of music to study and understand, not just for its own sake, but, you know, it has shown up, the sort of building blocks of Getaran Jiwa have shown up even in my future compositions. I suppose at one point, you know, we don't have, you know, 200 channels to choose from. You know, you have one or two TV channels, and so everyone was watching, everyone's consciousness was divided. Either you're watching this channel or you're watching this channel, or maybe you can receive Malaysia TV, then maybe this one and this channel. So people's focus was quite clear. So when a P.Ramlee thing go on, the chances of someone watching TV catching it will be there. Nowadays, that's why I say the whole scene is changed, because I can come up with a movie, for example, like Bujang Lapok, right? And if it appears on one of 200 channels, right, and there's so many people watching so many things, it will not have the same magnitude. So it was a period of the time, it was basically a period when people were able to be focused on what they were being fed, was quite musically as well as in films and so on and so forth, was through very few channels. And to me, you ask me which one I prefer, it's hard to say. I mean, both were great. You know, if I wanted to get on TV and do something, everyone will hear about it and see, and the publicity would be very, very clear, you know. But nowadays, it's not the same anymore. It's the attitude, you know, and your impetus. You know, many musicians start off with the intention of either they want to become very famous or they want to make a lot of money. And I think as an artist, if your impetus is always about how famous you can be, how much money you can make, how many people will love me, then that's the recipe for disaster. But if your impetus is to create the best possible music you can create, and then after you've created it, then maybe you involve the marketeer or you do your own marketing or whatever. But people sometimes musicians start off with worrying about popularity, money first, and that's, to me, a recipe for either a very short career or recipe for disaster. We concentrate, just be the best musician you can be, write the best music you can write, play the best music you can play, and then I think the universe or whatever will make sure that, you know, it will help you along. And then after that, of course, you still have to connect with the channels and the avenues to get your music heard, but the focus should be on the music first.